Salutations, everybody. It is Maddie here today. After a nice weekend off, I am feeling so rejuvenated and ready to hit the ground running this week. So let's do it. Starting off with some information that was data mined by folks who dove right into the Fallout 76 beta. So we're talking about Team Deathmatch, brand new perk cards. I mean, a lot of them. So prepare yourselves for that. And on top of that, new power armor paints that are likely coming through the Atomic Shop. So let's get into it, starting off with Team Deathmatch. Now, the way we learned about Team Deathmatch was through a data mine that brought out loading screen text. So the first three texts are going to hint towards that. Team Deathmatch is timed. The highest scoring team within the time limit, or the first team to score 50 points, wins. Eliminate enemy players to score points and bring victory for your side in Team Deathmatch, and the arenas for Team Deathmatch are randomly picked from one of the many locations within the Appalachia. Now, this may not be news to some folks, because back when Danny O'Dwyer had actually interviewed Jeff Gardner, here's what Jeff had to say about TDM in Fallout 76. We wanted to make it fun for single player, we wanted to make it fun for our teams. Our team limit right now is 4, so we wanted to make it fun for co-op 4-person gameplay, and we wanted to make it fun for bigger 12-on-12 deathmatches. So we're really trying to jam it all in and hope it works out. Now, at first I thought maybe this was through events, because I had stumbled upon an event which was reenacting the Civil War, and it was a PvP event. So I thought maybe that's what they meant by deathmatch, but it seems like based off those loading screen texts that we are actually going to get a fully functioning team deathmatch mode at some point in time in this game, and that it's going to take a GTA Online style approach, where it's going to carve up a section of the map and make that a place where folks can join into team deathmatch. Now, I imagine there will also be a quick play option so that you can match with people across a bunch of other servers who are trying to play team deathmatch. If you're just trying to do 12v12 team deathmatch within the confines of that one server you are in, it's going to end up not working out, because not everybody in the server, or almost everybody, is going to want to play TDM. Everyone has their own objectives when they sign into the game. So hopefully they've got all that figured out. But yes, we're likely getting a TDM mode. Now let's get into the bulk of perk cards. It begins with Critical Banker. Rank 1, you are a patient battlefield tactician and can save a critical hit to be used in vets when you need it most. You can now save 2 critical hits in vets when you need them most. And lastly is rank 3, where you can save 3 critical hits when you need them most, and banking a critical has a chance to save an additional. So you can save 1 and then it can end up being 2 with that bonus luck. So that could actually be really helpful in a fight against one of the tougher creatures like a Scorch Beast or the Grafted Monster. Next is the Mysterious Stranger. Maybe there is a human NPC out there, so the Mysterious Stranger will appear occasionally, more often, and appears so much in VATS he knows you by name. I like that last one, actually. Tenderizer makes your target receive 5% more damage, 6% more, and 7% more for 5, 7, 10 seconds after you attack. That sounds something along the lines of maybe a strength perk card, doing more damage after you have already hit them. Next is Overly Generous. Rads increase your chance to inflict 25 rads with melee attacks, and Overly Generous rads increases your chance to inflict 50 rads with melee attacks. So this might mix well with folks who really like to keep their mutations and not use too many radaways, and pretty much you can use the additional rad damage if you're doing a melee build. So a lot of melee focused perk cards so far. Penetrator, this one may be OP if it is in team deathmatch. No VATS accuracy penalty versus enemy body parts blocked by cover. So as long as you are close enough to them, you don't suffer any type of accuracy penalty, and you can pretty much shoot them right through the wall. So that is something that I hope is banned for Team Deathmatch, because if I'm trying to hide from someone and they can just shoot me through the wall, that won't be fun. Wasteland Whisperer, aim your gun at a creature below your level for a 50 and last rank 75% chance to pacify it. So maybe things get a little wild and you need to calm it down, stop this beast from attacking you. One of your friends has the Wasteland Whisperer perk on, save someone's life by pacifying it. And lastly, Lucky Break. Slight chance your equipped armor will repair itself when struck, will repair itself even more, and will greatly repair itself when struck. So this one's interesting. I kind of wish it was the weapon, because this game has a little bit of the Breath of the Wild syndrome, where it feels like it's breaking every 10 seconds. But I like it also because it encourages me to stay on top of it, continuously go back to the workbench, and stay in that part of the gameplay loop. Next page, we got Dry Nurse, which is a charisma perk. You have a 50% chance to keep your stim pack when you revive another player. Really useful, because if you're fighting boss creatures, man, you can burn some stim packs up trying to revive a 4-man team. Fire in the Hole, see a throwing arc when throwing toss weapons, and they fly 15, 30, and 50% further. This one, I don't know how much that would be worth it because I don't even have an explosives build, and explosives are really useful in this game, let me tell you what. And I don't really ever need to throw them super far where I need a 50% additional arc, but the actual arc itself would be nice. Next, fireproof endurance. Immediately gain 20, 40, and 60 fire resistance. Not too bad. Seems very creature specific. Would be helpful if you got that in a pack rather than spent your actual points on it. Next is night eyes. Gain night vision when sneaking between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. I really like that one, man. That could be really cool because I've heard some people complain that when they're playing on the PS4 Pro with this game that sometimes it can get like a little dark for them. So maybe this is something that is either a technical error or we can have it fixed with night eyes. Robotics expert, hack an enemy robot for 25, 50, and 75% chance to pacify it. Strong back, I think everybody's going to get this at this point in time. Gain 10, 20, 30, 40 to carry weight. There's a huge carry weight problem in Fallout 76 because the stash has a limited amount of space in there. And lastly, is sun-kissed, slowly regen radiation damage between the hours of 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. and quickly regen radiation damage between the hours of 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. So pretty much it saves you having to use Radaway if you have a ton of radiation on you. I don't know how useful this will be because Bethesda's really encouraged mutations for the end game, chasing down mutations, trying to hold on to them. And if you have a perk card that's pretty much getting rid of your radiation as you just explore the world without putting anything on you, that might screw you over. So I don't know how worth it this one will be later on. We're still not done yet. There are so many. Storm Chaser. Gain health regeneration while outside rain or radiation storms. Gain high health regen while outside during rain or rad storms. Critical Savvy. Critical hits now only consume 85, 70, and 55% of your critical meter. So combine that with the Critical Banker and you can get yourself a lot of critical hits. Last Laugh, you always drop a live grenade from your inventory when you are downed, not too shabby. Sneak, you are 50% harder to detect while sneaking, so this is an interesting inclusion potentially because there is the agility special stat itself which ties to your ability to be detected while sneaking. So I don't know if this would actually ever conflict with that actual stat or if it would add on to it. Nerd Rage, while below 20% health, gain 20, 30, 40 damage resistance, 10, 15, 20% damage increase, and a steady 15% AP regen. Grenadier, your explosives detonate with 50% the larger radius and twice the radius. I really like that one because there are so many times I will get swarmed by enemies and it's just me doing a solo run and there are so many around me and I throw a grenade thinking I'm about to blow up a ton of them, but the radius can be so tight. Long shot, your rifles have 10%, 20%, and 30% more range and have even more accuracy when sighted. This would be really helpful, so I hope this ends up being added to the game. And Tormentor, your rifle attacks have a 5 and 10% chance of crippling limbs. This one, I wonder if it's actually when you're using the RB or R1 to melee attack the enemy with your gun, or if it's actually when you're shooting them with your rifle, because rifle shots versus rifle attacks, maybe it's just me being picky with the words, but it's something I noticed. We're getting there, I promise. Tank Killer, your rifle ignores 12, 24, 36, and 40% of armor and has a 3, 6, 9, 8, that's weird, percent chance to stagger. So I imagine that's probably 12% chance to stagger, which this is once again probably a really, really helpful perk card. Ordnance Express, explosives weigh 30, 60, and 90% less. That is going to be awesome because I actually have a weapon from a quest I completed that is a 6-pound fat man. And imagine if I had Ordnance Express on top of that where all the mini nukes weighed 90% less. You could just go to town, man. Couple that with Demolition Expert, which is next, where your explosives do 20, 40, 60, 80, 100% more damage, and you're pretty much unstoppable. Travel Agent, you pay 30% fewer caps for fast traveling. I can see why this might be optimal early on when you're struggling to get some caps, or maybe you want to hold on to them for some of the later game mutations and stuff that you can buy at stores, but personally, I don't think fast traveling was ever that expensive. I mean, I traveled across the map one time and it cost me 24, which isn't all that bad. Escape Artist, sneak to lose enemies and no longer affects, and running no longer affects stealth. So I find the second part of this a little more helpful. Woodchucker, collecting wood yields 100 and 200% more, really nice. And this last one, man, Chemist. You get double the quantity when you craft chems and triple the quantity. So if you're making one of the diluted stim packs with purified water and stim packs, they usually give you two at a base value. So you can have 6 stim packs every time you sit down and craft with a fully upgraded chemist perk, which, yes, the diluted ones aren't as good, but you could just have so many stim packs, which, man, if you don't have the farmer perk, this is a good route to take. Ammo smith, 40%, 80%, 100% more rounds while crafting ammunition. Sniper, which is a perception perk, improved control and holding your breath for 25, 50, and 75% longer while aiming through a scope. Scatter shots, shotguns now weigh 30, 60, and 90% less, and you reload them 10, 20, and 30% faster. I really like the idea of extra reload speed because as a strength build, shotguns are my go-to firearm, so being able to reload them a little bit quicker is very helpful. Fortune Finder, you hear directional audio when in range of a cap's stash. Frayed jeans, a mutation's positive effects are vastly improved while affected by its serum. Once again, this is probably going to be a really good late game perk card that people are going to want to hang on to. Enforcer, your shotguns gain a 5, 10, 15, and this one's crossed out, but 20% stagger chance and a 10, 20, 30% chance to cripple limbs. Another shotgun perk card, Skeet Shooter, your shotguns have improved accuracy and spread, and your shotguns have even better accuracy and spread. A lot of routes for folks who want to use shotguns at this point in time, as well as rifle. Animal Friend, we already went over. All night long, you suffer 20, 40, 60% less from hunger and thirst. Outlaw, this one will be quite interesting, given if someone tries to grief. Your maximum bounty timer is reduced by 20, 40, and 60%. I've only ever seen in my entire time with the game one person wanted and they disappeared pretty quickly on the map. I think it's because there's so many rules in place that we're really not going to see too many people who are wanted. So I don't think people should invest in this unless it comes through a perk card pack. Rad Sponge. When affected by rads, you periodically heal 80, 140, and 200 rads on nearby teammates. So that's definitely got to be a charisma perk card. Exotic Weapons Master. You can now craft crossbows, black powder guns, and more. And then you can also craft rank 3 weapon mods. So there is the exotic weapons perk card. We had actually already known about that, but I believe when it gets to the later game, there's expert and master perk cards that are added on that kind of increase them even more. So science expert, you can craft rank 2 energy gun mods, and crafting energy guns now costs fewer materials. That's huge because they're always asking for crystals, which are really hard to come by in Fallout 76. And science master, you can craft rank 3 energy gun mods, and your crafted energy guns have improved durability. Are you guys ready? This is the last page of new perk cards potentially coming into Fallout 76, or these could be ones very well that are not in the game at all and were just left out data, maybe cut entirely, but still worth talking about. Wrecking Ball, you deal 40, 80, and 120% damage to workshop objects. So if you're trying to destroy someone else's workshop that has been claimed, one of the open world areas, not an actual camp someone has put down, this might be helpful. Radicool, the greater your rads, the greater your strength. So you can have a max of +5 strength. So that's really, really good if you're a strength build. Homebody, gain gradual health regeneration while in your camp or workshop, and gain improved health and limb regeneration while in your camp or workshop. This may not sound amazing, but as someone who during the most recent beta session went ahead and kind of exploited the camp where I would post it up, put a bunch of turrets, lure the high level enemies to me, farm them pretty much, loot their bodies for gear, having improved health regeneration and limb regeneration while you're in there where you could take them on, or if you're getting raided by, for example, I fought a ton of anglers at one point in time in a workshop we claimed and they were kicking my butt. If I had this improved health and limb regeneration, it might have been a little easier. So this one might be a little underrated. Super Duper, when you craft anything, there's a 10, 20, 30, and 40% chance you'll get double the results. Not too shabby. Stabilized, in power armor, heavy guns gain more, even more, and excellent accuracy and ignore 15, 30, and 45% of armor. Powersmith, you can now craft advanced power armor mods. Crafting power armor now costs fewer materials, and your crafted power armor now has improved durability. This one seems familiar. This one actually might be in the game, or there's some type of power armor crafting perk card in there. And Power Patcher, your power armor breaks 20% more slowly and 40% more slowly and becomes cheaper to repair with both renditions. Oh my gosh, wait, there are more. Thunder Thighs, sprinting in power armor consumes half as much and no extra fusion core energy. You can really go through fusion cores in this game, and I don't feel like it's gonna be like Fallout 4 where I had like 90 come end game. but this one might be one taking a look at. Portable power. All power armor parts and chassis weights are reduced by 25, 50, and 75%. Fix it good. You can repair armor and power armor to 130, 160, and 200% of normal maximum condition. The fix it upper, you can repair workshop objects to 130, 160, and 200% of normal maximum condition. Home defense, this one is already in the game. And locksmith, you can craft level 1 locks, 2 locks, and 3 locks for your camp or workshop. I think this one may be more useful in a public workshop, because when you're in a camp, you're probably storing everything inside your stash, which no one else can access. Last one, I'm cured. Your chance to successfully cure any disease is improved by 25, 50, 75, and double. Right on, man. So a lot of perk cards there. It didn't seem like anything was directly tied to a event or a holiday, which I think a lot of us were expecting. Maybe they're just going to be content packs. Maybe we'll never see these perk cards be put into the game. Who exactly knows? But the last thing I want to go over is the most recently data mined power armor paints. Now, these were textures extracted from the beta. They imported them into Fallout 4, so they're actually photos. I don't want to show the pictures, I'm just going to show the names, because I know that game companies are really touchy on when you show actual like content versus just talking about it. So let's go over the names. I promise you, you'll be able to imagine them yourselves. They're pretty obvious, because they're Santa, Camo, West Virginia, Carbon, Vault-Tec 1-2, Patriot, Hot Rod Redo, Full Album, and then the last two are President and Proto, which I was reading the thread here on Reddit, and it seems like those two are in the game, and there's apparently also going to be a brand new power armor frame called Ultra, so that'll be interesting to learn about. But we have a lot of decals there. It seems like Santa is obviously going to be something tied to a Christmas event, but we're not seeing anything Thanksgiving related, which was something I was half expecting. Now, that Reddit post will be linked in the description down below if you really want to see the pictures for yourself. I wanted to make sure I avoided some form of spoilers there. But that'll do it for all the information that was data mined in the last couple of days over the weekend that I have for you. So I'd love to hear your thoughts on all those new perk cards, the team deathmatch mode, and the power armor paints. This is a massive video, so I hope you guys enjoyed all the information that came your way, and I'll catch you guys next time. Be sure to follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook. Those links are in the description down below, along with my Patreon. Do consider supporting that, as it fuels all the content we create here. Stay sexy, stay active. I love you all. Peace.